Good evening. Thank you for the opportunity to geek out on one of my favorite topics, terroir. And when I say that word, who in the audience actually knows what I'm talking about or has heard it? A couple of us? All right, perfect. Well, if we're to examine the definition or you Google it, per se, you're gonna find something along the lines of the environmental and climate effects that factor into the taste of wine and the grapes that produce it. But that's a very limiting term. So what I want to investigate today is how we can kind of reclaim this term inside of our lexicon. And if you've never heard of the term before, maybe we can implant it into your brain in a way where you can use it to experience what you consume in a different way in the future. So the reason this is so important in this valley is it is just rich in terroir. Delta County produces so many interesting components of terroir because of agriculture, wilderness that surrounds the rivers and lakes, and just ambient factors that feed into the products that we make. And there's no scientific evidence that says that terroir actually affects our flavors. And I'm not here to disprove that today. What I'm here to talk to you about is how do we actually taste? And the fact that every single one of us tastes completely different. Now, if we look at these various products that we produce inside of Delta County here, there's a couple things they have in common. One is the amount of time it takes to create them into a product. And two is how much energy goes into it and the variability of them. When we look at livestock and wild game, our animal groups here inside of Delta County taste different and specific to our county and are a little bit different than anywhere else in the world where they are made or hunted. Coffee comes from a tropical environment and is brought here to be roasted. Horticulture is an artificial environment that has its own terroir. Agriculture, we have this wilderness surrounding us with all of these domesticated things that live right next door to each other. So when we're talking about this, we're talking about climate, we're talking about soil, we're talking about topography, and then we're also talking about the surrounding plants. All these are these micro elements that feed into what we actually taste when we are tasting it. Wine is a classic example because if you just take ambient yeast and don't wash the grapes before you make it into wine, all of those elements are going to go into the final flavor that we taste. Similarly, if you imagine a field of barley that has a ton of pollen glazing it, or someone yanking a potato out of the ground, those type of mediums have all of those factors that vary into what we actually taste when we try a spirit. When we go back to something like coffee, we're taking that environmental factor, we're using the processing time, which gives us more contact with the overall terroir, and then we're roasting it in a different environment like we do here in Delta County. These guys, for example, they have some common components. Their diets, the grains or the grass that we're feeding them have components of terroir affiliated with them, as well the water that they drink comes from a very similar source. When we look at meats and cheese, they have that similar component of time where we have this new application where our environment is able to affect the overall product that we have at the end of their life when we are actually serving them to someone. So on top of that, with terroir, we got to think about how we actually taste. Every single person in this room tastes things differently than the person next to them. And the reason being is we have between 5,000 to 10,000 taste buds, but simultaneously, we're tasting 70% of what we do through our noses, which is kind of crazy. Just think about that for a minute. So the cool part about this is the way that that transmits to the brain is it goes to the frontal cortex, and that's also where we create long-term memories. And this is kind of the romantic part about food and drink, is the two intertwine. They go hand in hand when we think about the experiences that we've had in the past. And so this is a classic example. Scientifically or medically, some of us just don't like cilantro. But the rest of us, we have to be honest with ourselves when we say, cilantro tastes like soap. Well, how do we really know what soap tastes like? Maybe we had a little bit of a loose mouth when we were younger. The takeaway here is that when you're experiencing things inside of this valley or inside of this county that are produced here. Think about everything else that is produced right next door. Think about all of the beautiful things that we've created inside of this arena of terroir inside of Delta County. And then think about the fact that you are tasting it completely different than the person that you're enjoying it with. Thank you very much, guys.